What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Steven. This is Steven in Stereo. And yes, I am that excited. I even like have a coffee because I knew what was going to happen. Taylor Swift dropping with her little surprise. Give us one day, 2 days ahead to get ready for things. She dropped one of her vault releases from Fearless. Now, I've seen on Twitter that like people have heard like cuts of this song before, but obviously not Taylor's version. It was the original on the Fearless album. Obviously, I have not heard this track. So this is You All Over Me featuring Maren Morris, and this is Taylor's version, and I'm really excited. I know she worked with Aaron again, and God, we've just had so many great moments. Like seeing her at the Grammys was just such an incredible moment. It gets us really excited to be able to actually see her live. But right now, I know she's working on re-recording albums and we are getting stoked. So, before we get into today's video, I just wanted to plug my Patreon. I do so much Taylor Swift related content over on Patreon. I did her Grammy performance over there. I did all of the Red Tour, all of 1989. I did the Folklore Long Pond Sessions movie as a watch party. There's just so much over there. Folklore and Evermore both have full uncut album listening parties over there as well. So yeah, if you want a ton of Taylor Swift exclusive content, Patreon. Also, don't forget to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and check out twitch.tv/positivesteven where I do live reactions and I play video games and I have a good time with everybody. I'm throwing headphones on. Maren Morris has a wonderful voice. Taylor, obviously, in the Fearless era has given us a little bit of that country twang, at least I gather from the one song we've heard from the re-recording. So this is You All Over Me, Taylor's version. Oh yeah, yeehaw, Taylor is back!
Once the last drop of rain has dried off the pavement, shouldn't I find a stain?
But damn, she sounds so good right here.
Off the pavement, shouldn't I find a stain? But I never do.
It just makes me happy to hear a harmonica in the back.
The way the tires turn stones on old county roads, they leave a muddy underneath. Reminds me of you.
Fuck. I'm just hearing that little bit of twang coming out, and this just gets me so hyped for the Fearless era. So hyped.
They leave a muddy underneath. Reminds me of you. You find graffiti on the walls of old bathroom stalls. You know you can scratch it right off. It's how it used to be. But like the dollar in your pocket.
Oh yes.
It's been spent and traded in. You can't change where it's been. Reminds me of me.
Wait, I love that line. You can't change where it's been. Reminds me of me.
You can't change where it's been. Reminds me of me.
So fucking good.
I lived and I loved.
Oh, the harmonies!
You got burned, held out, and held on. God knows, too long and wasted time. Lost tears, swore that I'd get.
Let me have my moment for a second. So, obviously, like, Fearless has so many tracks that were so big. And when this album first came out, I worked at this restaurant where they were constantly, all we could play was CMT. And so, at that time, you know, we were hearing a lot of Country Taylor. And that is what I always knew her as. This makes me really happy because I feel like when we got into Folklore and Evermore, I could feel hints of this kind of coming out. And it kind of makes me wonder when she was sitting down to decide what she wanted to re-record. I wonder if that crossed her mind, like, you know, hey, we're working together really well. And I'm starting to get like these good sounds. We should do Fearless. Like, I feel like vocally and just influenced currently, you know what I'm trying to say. I feel like Fearless is the way to go. Because I can, you, like I said, in those albums, you can hear moments of that coming out, and it just sounds so great here. Also, the harmonies with Maren right here, so good.
Here, but No amount of freedom gets you clean. I've still got you all over me.
Oh.
The best and worst day of June was the one that I met you. With your hands in your pockets and you don't you wish you had me grin. Well, I did, so smile.
Yes.
And melted like a child. Now every breath of air I breathe reminds me of then. And I lived and I learned. Had you got burned.
I just love that they're like really utilizing these harmonies with Maren because it creates such a beautiful moment here. Yeehaw Taylor is back. For the time being, we are so here to stand Yeehaw Taylor all the way.
I did so smile and melted like a child. Now every breath of air I breathe reminds me of then. And I lived and I learned. Had you got burned, held out and held on, God knows. Lost tears.
Yes.
Oh, that I'd get out of here. But no amount of freedom gets you clean. I've still got you all over me.
Come on. This is fucking iconic moments right here. Woo!
To turn around and see that we were never really meant to be. So I lied and
oh,
I cried,
yes.
And I watched a part of myself die. Cause no amount of freedom gets you clean. I still got you all over me.
Oh my God, I cannot wait for this album.
I still got you.
I know this seems so strange, but all of you, I think, right now can relate to what I'm about to say. I cannot wait for this album that already exists. Like, we have Fearless, and we love Fearless, but I think there is this beautiful moment where, again, we're talking about Evermore, we're talking, yeah, Evermore, Folklore, we're talking about these albums that, you know, Taylor owns, and Taylor put so much heart and soul into, and with that soul, being able to go back, feeling re-inspired and go back into an album that has already done so much numbers-wise, to be able to go back with the influence that you have now and with the maturity of your sound and obviously just with being a better artist in the sense that you're going to consistently get better as you go, and Taylor is one of those artists that continues to grow no matter what. When you have all those moments and you get to go back and revisit an album that you put out so many years ago and make it your way, like, in my opinion, there's just something so beautiful about that. And not a lot of artists can do that. Like, we've get re-recordings and, you know, remasters and things like that from bands all the time. And I feel like sometimes a re-recording, in my opinion, like, there's a couple bands I can think of off the top of my head where they've done a re-recording and, like, I wasn't very excited about it because there was nothing wrong with the original one. But in Taylor's shoes, I see a couple reasons why this is really awesome. So if you're maybe on the fence about her re-recording things, just remember that all of the drama that has been carried out with Big Machine and all those things regarding her masters, first and foremost, with just, like, without even sonically, just re-recording to be able to own your own content, though technically it's always been her content, but contractually she doesn't have the rights to her own album. So to have to re-record them anyways is such a daunting task. However, as a fan base, we're fucking stoked about it, right? Because we want Taylor to be getting that coin. And I mean that not just in the fact that I want her to be successful off the money. She earns it. Like, she earns it. She owns it. It's her shit, right? So, having said that, Now we go into the sonic value of this. Fearless sounds amazing to me. Taylor, in her area, like where she's at now musically and what she's doing and a lot of her influences, I cannot wait to see what some of these tracks end up doing. I can just tell you, like, right now that I cannot wait. Well, first off, hopefully Hey Steven is dedicated to me. It won't be, but hopefully it is. Personally, I'm so excited for You're Not Sorry and for White Horse. I feel like those two tracks, especially with the way Taylor is like doing music right now, those tracks are gonna be so hard hitting, and they already are, but I just see something really beautiful happening from them. I'm really excited to hear this vault version because it's one of those tracks, obviously, you know, for the last couple of years, you guys have been watching me follow Taylor's music. I believe I started in 2019 doing that, and I did all the albums, but there's still these unreleased songs, and I'm gonna actually get a chance to hear them the way Taylor meant for them to be, the way Taylor wanted us to hear them. And to me, that's a big deal as a fan. Even if I've only been a fan for a couple of years, it's something that I'm excited about. I have played the shit out of my Taylor Swift records. Like, I have listened to them so much. So to be able to get new material, I'm always gonna be excited. Plus, it's even more ammo for her to use when she finally goes on tour again. I honestly, with this album coming out, very soon, I have a feeling that like the track list of her tour is gonna be just insane, and there's gonna be so much content. Like, there's no way that every tour or every show is not like 2.5 hours long, because she's got a lot of material that we want to see performed live. Yeah, I just feel like there's gonna be a lot of cool stuff coming with this. I'm hoping for an Evermore Long Pond session. I'm hoping for a Fearless session movie. Just keep giving us content. We will give you all the money, Taylor. Please just keep giving us content. I'm really excited to have checked this out. I will say that I kind of wish Maren was featured more in the track. I'd love to hear her in the harmonies. It's just so beautiful. I just kind of wish she might have had a verse in this. So I'm hoping if there's any other features that maybe we get a little bit more of that artist personality to be able to come out as well. However, it is a Taylor track, therefore I'm totally okay with Taylor having the reins on this. Maren's vocal is so good to be able to harmonize with that, and it does add like a certain level of depth that you couldn't do with just one person, I guess, unless you multi-layered your own vocals. But it's actually really fun to see just another badass female artist on this album. I really hope you guys like today's video. Let me know in the comment section what you guys are thinking about this new release. I know some of you have heard it before. Don't forget to check out Patreon. So much exclusive content. I promise you will not be bored. Also, follow me Instagram and Twitter and Twitch. I love you all. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.